Philadelphia police shot plastic pellets filled with paint and pepper spray at crowds of people in West Philadelphia. It is the second day of protest and civil unrest, and tensions are high. Looters are breaking into stores, and some protesters were setting cars on fire. The NBC10 investigator's camera is rolling as police try to disperse crowds at 51st and Market. Cab driver Noor Daniel is caught in the middle. You can see him touching his head and seeing the blood on his fingers, realizing he's been shot. He goes up to the police line asking why they shot him and pointing to his taxi. Disoriented and dizzy, a few people come to his aid. Eventually, he is treated by strangers. But panic sets in for Daniel. He tries to sit up and yells for an ambulance.
Ambulance, ambulance, please.
He wasn't a protester. He was trying to get his personal items from his taxi. It had been smashed and burned by protesters.
The intersection.
We caught up with Daniel nearly 2 months later. You can still see the mark near his right temple. He's thankful he was hit with what police call a less lethal munition.
I think for the guard, higher guard, please help me. Just I think first time is a real blood.
He says he has ringing in his ear and frequent headaches.
It's a lot of the pain. I just sleeping time is a and night time and morning time all time is this is the pain.
Police also shot less than lethal rounds at protesters who descended onto 676. The next day, Police Commissioner Daniel Outlaw defended the actions.
The option of deploying tear gas was selected only when it became evident that other options were not effective.
But a few weeks later, Outlaw and Mayor Jim Kenney apologized for the use of force against those protesters on 676.
I apologize sincerely to the peaceful protesters out there on that highway on June 1st, who were simply choosing to exercise their right to speak out against injustice and institutional racism.
At that time, he did not include what happened in West Philadelphia.
The mayor says the protest on 676 was different than the one at 52nd and Market Streets. He says the difference is here in West Philadelphia, there was looting and destruction to businesses and police vehicles.
In a statement regarding West Philly, the mayor now says in part, I fully regret the use of tear gas and some of the other force by police in that situation as much as I do its use the following day on I-676. The police department declined to comment for this story because the incidents are under investigation. But police spokesperson Inspector Sekou Kenabru showed us the weapons the department used against protesters.
The beanbags come out of it. I mean, it would fit in here compact. Out of a shotgun round.
Police also used plastic pellets.
It would be pepper spray in here, and it would come out of the same thing, an air pump type, just like a paint gun.
But they're less lethal. They're not non-lethal.
Biomedical engineer Cynthia Burr consults for the manufacturers of these kinds of weapons. She says projectiles such as beanbags and pellets can cause serious injury and even death. According to Burr, the pellets and beanbag rounds Philly police used during the protest are to be aimed directly at a person, not into crowds, and they're meant to be shot at center mass or limbs.
What we were seeing across the U.S., there was a lot of head injuries, and these rounds are specifically not to be, they're designed not to be shot at the head.
Dozens of protesters and residents filed lawsuits in early July alleging excessive use of force by Philadelphia police in its response to both I-676 and 52nd Street. One of the West Philadelphia residents suing the city is Crystal McBee. She says she was trying to get her granddaughter away from the crowd at 52nd and Market Street when she was overcome by tear gas and later struck by a pellet.
By the time I got to Chancellor Street, turned around, a bullet came and hit me right here in my head, and it swelled up instantly.
She considers herself lucky that she didn't lose an eye.
They shouldn't have never brought the SWAT team in the neighborhood with tear gas and shooting bullets. To me, that's dangerous.
As for Daniel, he too has hired a lawyer. He's had to pay out of pocket for much of the repairs to his taxi, but he is grateful that he is still alive.
My lucky.
The Philadelphia police changed its use of less than lethal force policy, at least for the time being. The city hired an outside group to investigate the department's response to the protest. You can read Mayor Kenney's full statement on the West Philly incident. It, along with our story, can be found on nbc10.com/use of force. For the investigators, I'm Claudia Vargas, NBC 10 News.